One morning in 1979, the residents of Wolverton awoke to find that an alien craft had landed in the middle of the town. No one was quite sure what it was, where it had come from, or whether any being inside was friendly or not. Some people said they saw lights moving about inside and heard faint music and the sound of many small wheels. It wasn't long before the townspeople noticed that the strange new arrival had effectively cut their beloved town in half, and they were suspicious. One afternoon, not long after it landed, a group of children were kicking a ball about in the square when they heard a clanking, rattling sound and all the shutters opened. Then there was a loud clunk and all the doors unlocked and flew open at once. They were so surprised that someone kicked their ball right through one of the open doors by accident. Lights flickered inside and they heard music. The only way to get the ball back was to go in. So, holding their breath and ready to run for it if anything scary happened, they tiptoed through one of the open doors. It was a bit confusing at first, with stairs and ramps heading in all directions, but they followed the music and soon came to a big square space in the middle, full of light and strange beings with wheels on their feet. But these Agorans didn't seem at all scary or threatening. They were dancing. One of the Agorans noticed the children and beckoned them over. They were offered some spare wheels to fix to their feet, and in no time at all, they were learning how to dance with their new friends. It was tricky at first, and there were a few bumps and bruises, but they soon got the hang of it, and it turned out to be brilliant fun. Round and round they whirled, and as they did so, more and more lights came on, and they realised that around the big space was an Aladdin's cave of shops and stalls, all full of lovely stuff, and all at very reasonable pocket money prices. It wasn't very long before the word spread throughout Wolverton, and everyone realised that despite their unfortunate landing site, the Agorans were friendly, could be communicated with through the exchange of small sums of money, and that dancing on wheels was the best fun. And so it was for the next 30 years or so. Generations of kids in Wolverton had somewhere to spend their pocket money. Somewhere along the way, the dancing on wheels ran out of steam, which was a shame, as many remember it fondly. And as the years went by, the Agorans found it harder and harder to keep their shops stocked and their trade going. And one by one, the lights started to go out. Finally, the message came beaming in from the mothership. There was another galaxy, far, far away, whose inhabitants had pocket money to spend and who had never even heard of little wheels, let alone could strap them to your feet and dance. And so the Agorans will be blasting off soon on another mission. Although the town will be joined up again, they'll be missed, and children will have to find somewhere else to spend their pocket money. No one will ever forget roller disco, though, and the wheels will keep on turning. They say that when the Agoran's robot comes out to wave, it will be the sign that the friendly dancing aliens will soon be on their way. And we wish them well on their journey.